Kyle Kuzma has evolved his game this season. It seems like he's fitting much better with the team and is getting comfortable with his role. Kuzma came into the league as a scorer. He was one of the Lakers' top scoring options back when the Lakers had their youth movement, and many expected him to be a star. Even when LeBron and AD came to the team, many of his teammates still expected him to be that guy. That really was his best attribute, and he was getting pressure from the fans, the media, and even his teammates to be that third star. Especially coming off the bench, many expected him to be a sixth man and bring that energy by scoring. But he was never able to become that player many people expected him to be. If we're being honest, he's probably never going to be that third star on a championship team. He's a role player, or what the Lakers like to call a star in your role, and it looks like he's finally embraced being a role player. Earlier this season, Kuzma signed an extension with the Lakers. This move seems to be working out for both sides. With this financial stability, he seems to have become more comfortable with his role. He no longer has that pressure to produce and put up numbers to try and earn that next contract. So now he's no longer forcing things and is simply fitting in and doing whatever the team needs from him. When you play the same position as LeBron and AD, it's going to be hard to find that much time on the court, let alone get touches. Not to mention that the Lakers also signed Dennis Schroeder and Montrezl Harrell, who are both better scorers than Kuzma. Kuzma understands that in order to get minutes and to be valuable on this team, he's going to have to do all the little things. He has to be able to play alongside AD and LeBron, meaning the ball will not likely be in his hands a lot. He won't be relied on to make plays. He's going to have to expand his game and not just be a scorer. He has to help the team with hustle plays, rebounding, and just play winning basketball without worrying about his numbers. And he's doing just that. This season, he's averaging a career high in three-point percentage, blocks, and offensive rebounds. He's not just standing around waiting for the ball. He's actively going after it and making hustle plays. He's grabbing 8.3% of the Lakers' misses. He's also averaging his lowest in turnovers per game. He currently has a career low in points per game, but with better scoring options elsewhere on the team, he doesn't have that pressure of scoring like he did previous years. He just has to let the game come to him and do whatever is necessary to win the game. He's playing winning basketball, and he's giving Vogel an easy choice to keep him in the game. He's becoming the perfect role player. He realized that he's going to have to be complementary to LeBron and AD, and to a lesser extent to Schroeder and Harrell, because it's highly unlikely that he's going to outplay them or outproduce them. He has also improved on defense, which is something this team prides themselves on. He is ranked in the 92nd percentile in NBA help defense and defending off of screens. He's in the 95th percentile at defending the pick and roll, the 98th percentile at defending drives, and in the 99th percentile at defending in isolations. He is now primarily a wing defender, which is something that the Lakers need. But he's also guarding fours and fives occasionally. And it's not like in previous seasons when you prayed to God every time he was guarding a center or a power forward. Now he's starting to hold his own against these bigger players. If he continues to improve his game, he can become a really great role player. And that's not something to scoff at, especially when you're a role player to LeBron James and Anthony Davis, two of the greatest players in the game today and possibly ever to do it.